You guys have maybe lately heard of a new macro that has released called Revolution Macro, and people have been asking the question of, is it actually a better and upgraded version of Natro Macro for any game stage, for any hive color? Are there any significant boosts in your honey per hour? And is it actually safe to use, most importantly? Because it has loads of crazy features that might sound better already, such as an insane gathering mechanic that uses AI, detecting what tokens are near you, which one your macro will prioritize overall, rather than going for useless tokens. We have the normal stuff as well, like dispensers, bug runs, polar bear quests that don't reset character, a useful planter mechanic for nectar, auto jelly for free mythics and any bee you want really and are just too lazy to spam click for, robo challenge, alt help or main even, free vicious stinger hop that is absolutely OP for red and white hive. I personally got 200 stingers in a day by just pressing F1, can get up to 400 though, depends on your RNG, and Mondo hop for free that gives crazy bitterberries, neonberries and dice as well, and even free mythic eggs if your luck is good enough, which I'ma just be honest bro, by itself that sounds insane and just way better than Natro Macro, because first of all this macro actually updates way more and most things are kind of bugged in Natro, like Vicious Bee for example, that barely even works most of the time. Anyway though, here actually is the guide on how to download it, on if it's actually safe, and a guide overall just for some good settings on how to use it and to just understand it, because there are so many interesting things that you want to know about and want to know how it works. Also, no, I'm not sponsored or anything. This is just a really nice thing for the Beastworm community on like a level up on basically just all kinds of farming. And no, it's not a hack. And no, it's not a virus or anything like that. Nothing will harm your PC with this, apart from, well, of course, your PC is going to be on for a while, but it does work on Windows and Mac OS too. So apparently that's a big thing for the people that are Mac. But the same exact thing has happened with Natro Macro when it was first new a few years ago. It just shows, are you sure you want to download? I know people may be scared, but no, this is literally just another one of them good things in the Beastworm community. The developer and macro owner has even came out of this too, showing why and overall just speaking about it, that it isn't. And I know the macro is still new, so it may seem scary, but it really isn't anything bad. And of course, no one's forcing you to download if you are that scared, and you can just wait some more time. But me personally, I'm gonna be getting them crazy stingers at least until a new update, and then macroing it with Beesmus if I turn blue. Anyway, who actually download this? And for the actual guide, here is their website. I will leave this in the description. All you're gonna do is literally just press download or Windows. You can join the Discord too. That is gonna help if I don't help overall, but I should explain it a crazy amount with timestamps and everything. But as you see, just go over here, download this as you see, then go to it, downloads over here, boom and boom, run it anyway, because as you saw there, it was Revolution Macro Publisher. So it's not even like it's anything bad. Anyway, over here though, let me just delete these and restart again and show you guys what you are greeted with when you first open the macro. So we have a press the plus button to gather at Thewood. Also, yes, I literally will be going through everything step by step, not that long, but just explaining it overall so you understand it. Anyway though, as you see, you can put whatever field you want and as much fields as you want. So me personally, I'm gonna do a pine tree for the blue hives, and then I'm gonna also do, I don't know, let's just say like a dandelion field for if you're early game trying to macro a quest. So first of all, for the blue hives, I would recommend AI gather or just the one you had before that you were just using to see if this will make you any better. Anyway, the AI gather is actually over here, as you see on the screen right now. It does show up that it goes to each token and whatever priority it is set over here, it will just go to that first whenever it detects it, because yeah, it does use some AI image detection. Whenever something pops up, instantly we'll go to it. Self-explanatory, over here we do have the time for it, so whatever the time you had, then obviously max backpack, I'd probably just say 100%. This return method, obviously walk to hive size as you had before with the other macro. Then over here, this is how the field is entirely built. So if you want to be in the middle, you just press this. If you want to be bottom, if you want to be top, left, right, like that. Usually you are over here though, if you are blue in this corner. So obviously you want to be there. Shift lock is really nice, I'm not going to lie, with AI gather, but you can experiment overall. Nothing else really has to be changed much though, because this is just normal, but you can experiment with things if you want to. There will be, of course, more additions for the blue hives, if you are wondering. But AI Gather is overall designed for blue. If it doesn't work for you, try other things. Not everything will work for the same person. So it really is playing around with things, seeing what works, seeing what doesn't. That is what blue is about overall. Same with the hive. There will be things coming out too, such as sticker stack implementation, if that's even a word, such as not leaving the field if Popstar is active, such as going to blue flower field with your alt account or with people in your server and pollinating and macroing there until the field boost is out. Yeah, things like that will be public and they will be out pretty soon, definitely before Beesmas. So this is why I'm getting familiar with this macro. It is looking like the next OP thing for me at least, but I know it will work for other people too, and there should be nice increases. If you are not blue hive though and just want other things, like for example macroing, then really just do anything corner X snake, just do like 8 minutes, whatever do what you want to do. If you're doing a quest, max backpack, things like that, just do walk to hive so you don't have to use the cannon if you are early game. And overall it should be kind of easy, I'm not gonna lie. Then the boosts are coming out. This is what I was talking about before. Settings, you of course want to have everything here, like what, but this is kind of self-explanatory too. Supreme, studs, full bag timeout, inactive honey timeout, just things like that, kind of easy. Inversion, obviously you want 0x maximum minute. Make sure you go through everything, by the way, just in case some things aren't ticked off. Token priority, you can change things if you want to, whatever you want more, but overall it's kind of set good by itself. I'd probably put the inflate balloons at like 100 myself, but that's really up to you guys what you want to play around with more. Anyway, for collect now, this is kind of self-explanatory. Obviously you just want everything. Bug run, kind of self-explanatory too, like what am I supposed to tell you. Quests will actually be out whenever you are watching this, so just press enabled and you should do about 20 to 40 polar bear quests. And yes, you literally won't even reset your character, at least from what I've been told. You're just gonna keep doing the same exact quest, and if you're gonna have a cooldown, then it's just gonna go back to the main gathering. So that's gonna be amazing. Remember, some things are still being worked on, so it is still in beta. I will make an updated video when more things come out and a massive update comes out. Then we have planters over here. Let me clear the schedule. Here is some footage right now of what you want to do, is literally either press manual or automatic. You do want to press at least 5 planters though, in my opinion. That is the best thing you can do if you are doing AI or just automatic. Really, manual planters is really OP as well. I would show it, but I've picked automatic, so here is how manual looks like. You can set whatever schedule you want, kind of like Natro Macro had it, but this one is just like you can really see what is actually going on here. Same in the status section, so it's really OP overall. I do recommend either having 24 hours though. You can also gather all the loot, do the planters every time you go to clock to not waste time if you have blue hive. Auto planters, nectar goals, you can get whatever you want over here. Priority as well, as you see, so whatever you need the most. Fields, you kind of want all the planters and all the fields, but you can disable some fields if you don't feel good with them or if you just don't have them, so it's faster. Like for example, if you don't want anything in dandelion, which I want the petal, just disable all apart from petal planters, so whenever it's doing automatic it will go there. Should be self-explanatory. If it's not, I'll help you out still. Planters, as you see, you can configure which are best in all. If you want a proper detailed guide on the best settings, I will make that, but this is more just how to use it. But it should be literally the same of what you had in Natro though. Over here we have in tools enabled, of course. It's actually really useful because you can get whatever move speed you want. I mean mutation, not move speed, like move speed is a mutation. You can get attack, convert, gather, move speed, probably mostly move speed for the pros. Then you can put whatever B you want. Let's say I want move speed on precise, spicy and vector, then boom, I could clear it if I want. Stop on gifted, stop on mythic, because yes, it can go until a mythic as well, or you can go for all types too. So that is actually really OP. RBC gather over here, I will talk about this more in a different video, but really OP because if you enable it, if you have an alt account but no one to help you and control it, all you're gonna press is enable. As you see, quest completion, it basically tracks your quest, sees what you are doing, which is why you had to press yes before, because it technically just controls and detects what field you are in, the quest progression over here, and what quests you are picking and doing. So the alt account goes there. So it is a really advanced version of macro. I will demonstrate it more in a separate video because that just needs a separate video overall, but it is really OP. I do recommend trying it out. Rejoin on reset, of course, maximum ults in the field, detecting quests after rounds, hotkeys and everything. I will update this more later on. Then for the vicious hop, probably the best thing ever, because this is what everyone is probably going to be using in the next few months, and I will make an updated video on this too if you still will be confused. But all you're going to do is just press enable, have roller on main, hop timeout. Me personally, I got it on 1. I don't want to be in the server if there's no vicious B. speed. As you see, 1 minute. Server hop, yes, I have this at like 2K. But for the main over here, claim hive when searching, of course. Vicious bee health can be low. I don't care, bro. Even if it's just barely any stingers, even if it's nothing, I don't care, bro. Joining new battles, of course, why not? And to make this work even, you do actually have to go in networking, and I would show it, but I don't want to leak my PC thing, but it should automatically connect. This is why another thing, why it flags it, because it connects to your PC. No, it doesn't steal anything. No, it doesn't do anything. Trust me, because I would have been hacked by now. So no, it doesn't. I know it's scary. All it literally does is just leaves the game, as you see, and joins another game. It doesn't have access to anything else, and it can't, because then I genuinely wouldn't make a video on it as I checked everything. But it is safe. I've been using it for a while. Even here's me using it right there. Anytime it's nighttime, genuinely rejoins, or it stays in the game actually. It goes to Pepper. Gift lock, if there's nothing under the field, it goes to Mountain, nothing there. Like that, goes to Spider, nothing there. Goes to Cactus, nothing there. If there's something in Rose, it goes to Rose. But it does have a really interesting and unique pattern. In my opinion, it is really OP, because I've gained literally 200 to 400 stingers in a day, depending how good your RNG is, depending how good your PC is to handle most things. But it overall should be pretty easy. And all you're gonna do is press F1, and like that, you'll get a crazy amount of stingers. So please try it out for yourself, and let me know if you guys like that too, because we do have Mondo Hop over here too, for the people that need bitterberries, neonberries, loaded, not loaded, but normal dice, and overall a chance to get a free mythic egg. Exact same thing as with the vicious hop I just explained. All you gotta do is press enable networking on start over here, and boom, should work. It's just gonna hop servers whenever the start of the hour when Mondo Chick spawns, and you should be good. It's gonna kill it every time. Over here, nothing exactly too much to worry about apart from 60 frame rate, of course. Most things don't really need to be configured. Like, obviously, you need your move speed. I probably have like 33.33 right now. Camera sensitivity, you wanna have it at whatever you have here. So I have 0.84 just to make sure everything works perfectly. And overall, everything does seem way better than Natro Macro. I will make an updated video with better settings. I'm still learning it myself overall to get the best settings for everything. But I did want to show you guys that this macro is a thing right now, that you should definitely be trying to use it, even if you're red, blue, white, seeing if you make any differences for the new updates come out for this macro, because I'm gonna be honest, bro, it's looking crazy. Like, wow, this is overly better than Natro, in my opinion. Not an ad, not anything. I'm just trying to show you guys the best things that are currently out there. But an updated guide will be really soon with the best settings and the best everything.